Okay, so a lot of you may know now that the upcoming Dragon Ball movie that has been announced for 2018 is going to be very heavily focusing on and, kind of pushing forth new Saiyans in light of, everything that's going on right now. And that's going to be kind of the main focus of, the most powerful warrior race in all the universes or whatever, the Saiyans. So it's going to be very heavily focusing in on that. And you got to think for a second, okay, wait a minute. Up until this point, and unless they really change it or they go the route of like how they used to do the films, where the films were just completely one-offers that could have happened at any, or can't, shall I say, happen at any given point, unless they go back that route, which I just don't see them doing that, considering Battle of Gods and Resurrection F felt like they were, true to the anime and manga. They didn't feel like they were completely, out the way or whatever. Then they're probably going to continue on with the whole theme of the last true-blooded Saiyans, around are Goku, Vegeta, I guess technically, Vegeta's brother, and whatever the cast that we have now. So they're not gonna say in Universe 7, shall I say, that there are more Saiyans that survived than they've just been somewhere. It's possible, and you never know if they did it. It'd kind of be like okay, but I think similar to what they like to do with Superman, although in the comics they kind of break away from it. But essentially, he's supposed to be the last son of Krypton, the last one from Krypton, period. And then yeah. You have Supergirl and you have these people here that are coming, Mala and all this shit. They just had a bunch of people, and I'm not sure if Mala was from Krypton. But anyway, the point being is that he was the last son of Krypton. And, going into a lot of these things, introducing more and more and more, it takes away from the uniqueness of what they bring to the table and what they are. And again, that's that they're the last of a really awesome breed known as the Saiyans. So you got to think, okay, well, if this is going to focus on potentially a new Saiyan villain, a new Saiyan protagonist, or whatever, where are they going to come from? Well, we know that Universe 6 has Saiyans because they're, the mirror of us, Universe 6 and 7 or whatever. So then you got to think they're probably going to come from there. Now, we've seen the introduction of new Saiyans with the recent arc, the Tournament of Power. Leading into it, we got the Caulifla and Kale. Before that, with the Universe 6 tournament, we got Kaba. So we've gotten new Saiyans being introduced to the franchise to begin with. So there's already new ones, but we still have had this thing where it's kind of been hyped up in a way, if you think about it, from Vegeta. Of essentially, well, there's a time where we want to go to Planet Saddle or Salad, or I'm gonna go with Salad. I don't want to say salad. So Planet Salad, which is the original Saiyan planet in Universe 7, that was before they became Planet Vegeta. They were Salad, and in Universe 6, they never advanced and became Planet Vegeta. They stood as Salad. So he's been wanting to go there for a while. I think this movie, depending on what we do with it could kind of fall in the vein of like a one-offer in a way. If you think about it, like, hey, in the Broly movies, for example, I think the first one, if I'm not mistaken, or it might have been one of the cooler ones, actually, now that I think about it, they were just going off the planet Namek. They had a little mission that they were on, or it wasn't even necessarily a big deal or whatever. They could go the same route with this. Is like, okay, Kaba wants to introduce Vegeta to the King of Saiyans here, King Salad, I'm guessing, or whatever the hell his name will be, and maybe it'll be a mirror of Vegeta or something along the lines of that. But we're gonna go maybe in that direction, and then upon arrival, things are missed because maybe Kaba's been under this illusion that the Saiyans are good, but there's something underneath the surface. Maybe the King's a piece of shit. But also, a lot of it is talking about this Yamoshi guy, because we just got word regarding the Yamoshi guy, the first Saiyan that is also pretty much the energy of the Super Saiyan God. Essentially, he was wandering, looking for the person that would be his successor, so to speak, or whatever. So we had that Yamoshi thing that was announced. And honestly, if they're gonna include that, and again, it's gonna have to have some sort of threat, maybe the original Super Saiyan God or the original Super Saiyan of Universe 6 will show up. and we'll be able to see him, and maybe he'll, you know, inherit somebody's body. Who knows? Maybe it could turn Kale into a complete bad person, and we'll have another Broly movie, technically, and the Super Saiyan God of that world is inside of her, and then we'll have an issue there. I guess that's a possibility as well. So I'm assuming that maybe they can do something like that, but honestly, they could really do whatever they want. They could introduce new Saiyans or whatever for this film, too. Personally, I'd like there to be new Saiyans. I'd like for us to, you know, arrive at there, be able to reunite with Kaba. Like, this could perfectly, if you think about it, depending on how long they go with the Tournament of Power, this could take place between the Tournament of Power and whatever new arc the anime is about to go into after the Tournament of Power. Put it right in there, even though the movie is going to be at the end of 2018, but regardless, it's still going to be in 2018, which the Tournament of Power will probably last a few more months, I'm imagining, in real time. So there's a possibility they could fit it in right there. A visit to Planet Saddle will be the initial goal and theme, and then it slowly leads into the chaos, and, you know, again, being able to reunite with Kaba, maybe where we could go with it, which would be perfect, now that I think about it, introducing everything that they're talking about is after the Tournament of Power, Universe 7 wins, they get the Super Dragon Balls, wish everybody back, the Planet King, or the King of Saiyans on Planet Salad says, yo, I want to thank you, please come over to our planet so we can give you a proper thanking, and then bam, Vegeta and the crew get over there, and that's when things go haywire, and possibly Goku essentially, or well, Goku and Vegeta, but Goku really essentially being the successor to Yamoshi, has to fight whoever becomes the successor to the Yamoshi of Universe 6, which again, it could very well be Kale. It could be that they could just make another Broly movie just using Kale in a guise, so to speak. So there's a possibility there. It could be that we get Kefla out of this, or again, some new baddies that aren't really Saiyans, but they use the Saiyans from here. I don't know. I'm looking forward to this film regardless, because one, it's going to be very Saiyan centric, and maybe as a Dragon Ball fan is very, very mainstream of an answer to be like, yeah, I like Saiyans. That's kind of like people in the Naruto fandom that like the Uchiha, or, you know what I'm saying, it's like that's very shallow or mainstream or whatever you want to call it to have of as an opinion. But nevertheless, I like the Saiyans, and so the fact that this upcoming film 2018 is going to be focused on Saiyans, it's going to be very Saiyan heavy, it's going to potentially, if it is Saiyan heavy, have some Yamoshi in there, connect the dots. It could be a really big battle of the gods. Essentially, this could be even tagline Battle of Gods 2, if you think about it, because this could actually be a Super Saiyan God versus a Super Saiyan God. I would love it. I would love to see more transformations. I guess, with my opinion, and again, there's a lot of people that would say, oh, but that's the shallow nonsense of Dragon Ball, we don't care about any more transformations, but I still like it. When we get the new Super Saiyan Blue, I was ecstatic. When we got God Mode, I was ecstatic, and I'm gonna keep on, you know what I'm saying? Like, I really get hyped about this. Ultra Instinct, we just got not that long ago, so whatever we get out of it, Saiyan-wise, it'll be cool, and again, if they wanna, I guess, recycle with Kale, it'd be fine, too. It just, I want a good fight, and I think Kale would be able to if she somehow inherits the spirit of Yamoshi of Universe 6. Just only time will tell. Kind of curious what you guys think, though. What is your opinion and predictions and theories regarding what this upcoming film for Dragon Ball is going to be about in 2018? Do you think that the Saiyans that are going to be used are going to come definitely from Universe 6? Is my little theory fanfic there going to be legit, where this is after Tournament of Power, the Saiyans of Universe 6, the King, tell them, hey, we want Goku and Vegeta to come over so we could properly thank them, and that's where shit goes down. Also, about the villain, do you think he's going to have any type of connections to Yamoshi? Do you think maybe Universe 6 Yamoshi is going to show up? Or, because again, if Yamoshi is really dead in our world and Goku is pretty much his successor, that doesn't necessarily mean that the Universe 6 Yamoshi is gone completely. He could still be alive to this day, or he could get reincarnated. There's just so many possibilities that they could go with. And yeah, I think it'd be great, because the Tournament of Power has been a pretty successful arc. The Goku Black arc was, I think, the epitome thus far, viewership wise but the Tournament of Power has been bringing in the viewership, so I wouldn't be surprised if they would want to revisit this time period shortly after and squeeze in a film between, you know, the events of what's to come and, you know, this movie or whatever the case may be. And your overall thoughts possible as predictions of what is going to go down with the 2018 Dragon Ball movie. I mean, we know there's going to be Saiyans, so we know there's going to be a lot of cool stuff. Oh, one more thing I definitely want to say. I want to see the return of the Great Ape form, Uzaru. I want Uzaru to show up. Let's get some of that monkey transformation stuff. I don't know if the Universe 6 Saiyans, maybe with this one, some new Saiyans show up and they, for whatever reason, inherit the ability to, you know, grow the tails again. Some crazy shit there. I want to see Uzaru. If you're going to be focusing in a movie about Saiyans, and this is really like, you know, the strongest warrior race, you have to go to the root of it. The tails definitely is a big deal that they need to include, so hopefully they do. But that's all I have for this discussion on the Universe 6 original Super Saiyan God and his connection to the 2018 film. Hope you enjoyed. If you like anything I had to say or enjoyed the video, drop me a like. I'd greatly appreciate it. And if you want more from me, make sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and do a little stalking on my Facebook to get more when the video ends. I'm Feneverworld, and as always, people, have an awesome day, and remember the golden rule: anime and manga for life. Have an awesome day, people.